We just want, so Frank will give us some space. Yeah. All right. We do a nice smooth push-up, Georges. Yeah. Nice and smooth.
Oh, George, all the way down.
Yeah, all the way down. Alors, on lève. Alors, quand tu prends le fusil pour une bonne push-up, on veut garder l'omoplate stable. Right? We need our shoulder blade stable. So what we want to do like this. We do the main jump. Just to make it feel this. Right like this. We want to be like this, mais on va tourner le fusil juste un peu sur un angle parce que sinon. Would please. Right? If my hand is like that, as I do my push-up, it's going to get all crumped up. So I want my hand to be like this to show us why, and I want to keep my elbow as solid as it can be. My other hand is down on the ground, so it's a little bit of an angle, and I go down nice and low, right to the point where I can rotate. Then I come back, and I push as hard off that barrel as I can. I take the weapon in the air, palm it, and hand it handle first, right? Treat the weapon like a real weapon. We never hand it back a barrel first to the person. Yeah. That's it. He then takes it. I wait in this position. So elbow right in, nice and tight.
Yeah, get that angle.
Otherwise, you're not going to learn the angle. Nice and tight, yeah? Or we just keep changing. You change your hand whenever you want, but when he hands it to you, you choose. Yep, that's it. Cool. It's too hard on your hands. You don't want to cut your hands. Your hand is sore. You're too weak, or whatever reason. If you're cutting your hands, hurting yourself, you can use a rubber gun, but you got to really hold. Alors, la première personne nous saute ton dos. On va commencer. Les positions qu'on va faire, c'est proche de la corde, deux mains proches, rallongées, moyenne distance. Right? So we have single hand close on the body, double stock, and then out. On va commencer juste avec celle-là. Alors, les règlements, c'est simple. Le pommeau sur le grand. Plus haut que les hanches, higher than the hips, toujours 30 à 45 degrés, 30 to 45 degrees. Ouais.
You don't want the sides of the head in your
body. On veut éviter l'accident avec les lattes. On veut pas going this way. Si c'est trop vertical, on slide, c'est plus frappé que mon torse. And so when I go here, I can my slide behind my body, my vest, my clothing. If I'm not away, I'm outside, my torse is on. So it has to be at an angle. Et ça doit être solide parce qu'on veut tirer à cette distance, c'est juste pour le principe. À 4 pieds, I'm 64 feet, somebody comes in, and I don't want to give him my gun. I don't want any chance of this arm, so I look at a pull, that's what I want. Alors pour cet exercice, c'est une calibration, it's a calibration. C'est très important, le fusil, c'est armé. La première façon de renforcer un bon alignement, c'est avec du stress, right? Nobody will keep it out of alignment when there's somebody on. So this is what we do, first one on your back. Take your gun, motherfucker! Lay on down. Yeah. He likes me. He really likes me. Feet standing there. Yeah. Put it in position. Alors, pommeau sur la torse. All right. Grab that gun in his hand with two hands. One. up to the river, sure. Okay, and I meant the pied entre, feet between the feet. You have to align the barrel of the gun with your stomach, so the way they'll know it does.
All right.
Joseph, you gotta get your arm right up. All right, push. That's it. Puis dans cet exercice maintenant, Joseph, you're gonna screw it out 45 degrees that way. You give him as much as you can take. Don't go all the way. Keep it back. Et on retourne, on touche juste le coude. Just the elbow. Don't bend the wrist. Just the elbow. Yeah, and the back. Just that. That's it. Simple. That's all. 2 minutes of this. Be easy breezy. We walk around to the new books. This is the lowest you go. We're doing the same drill, except now, no one in the room is gonna do it like you just did. So this is the lowest you go. 45, l'intérieur vers l'eau. Inside up to the top, 45 degrees. That's not inside to the top, 45 degrees. That's just inside to the top, 45 degrees. 30 à 45, ici. Coude en ligne, sur le planète, jamais comme ça. Jamais comme ça. Here, that's middle range, yeah? From here, on rallonge ton coude, ça va jamais passer ton torse. 45 degrees opposite. So it's 3 to 6 inches. That's it. Not this. It's this to that. That's it. Is that simple? All right. Le premier main. 45 vers le bas. 30 à 45 vers le bas. Le deuxième main, ici. Les pouces pliés ensemble par des coussins. I can touch my pads. It's the quietest applause. Right now there are crickets putting fingers in their ears. Or I can overlap. Alors j'avais des deux choix, mais c'est face à face. My choice. My choice. Mais c'est pas comme la position Weaver. It's not Weaver, les pouces sont pas dans le même sens, ils sont antagonistes. La chose le plus important, c'est qu'on plie pas les poignets. Pas un, pas deux. Never bend. Straight. Alors on va faire dans cet exercice, on va pousser le fusil dans le main. Comme on a fait avec le push-up, just like the push-up. On ferme les trois doigts en dessous pour tirer le fusil vers l'intérieur de ton pouce. So 1 second I do that. 2 seconds I do that. And as funny as it looks, I move and see that I can move my sternum and my shoulders. I give the gun to my partner. He grabs it, he pushes it in, closes the bottom, ferme les bas. Deuxième main, vérifier les poignets sont ensemble. Yep. So you're pushing the same way, that's Weaver. So thumbs up. Yeah. No. Festive. Yep. That way. Yeah. Tight. Tight. Yeah. Now don't bend your wrists. These are wrists.
Yeah. No, that's right. Not get them bent.
So. Exactly. Yeah. You and then wiggle. Simple. Back and forth. I walk around. Let's go. Yeah. Alors. Switch straight. Excellent. Tu vas prendre les poignets. You see, I'm so nice. I'm gonna grab your wrists. That's where they can't get. Yeah. Maintenant, je vais mettre toutes mes poids. This is all my weight, guys. So often when people are, oh, you can't take the weight, I'm doing this, it's because you can't do the push-up. I don't accept it. Do this, and put the gun right here. Yeah? All right, now Franco, small shoulder weight. C'est plus relax, move your sternum. Yeah. Alors, on veut bouger tout le corps à l'intérieur de cette corde. Yeah? That's it. It's 2 minutes. Enjoy it. Get it right there. Don't move the barrel off my face. Right there. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Right there. On a fait l'armée ici, c'est la même chose. Now we find the position we're comfortable with. 30 to 45 degrees, and we come up tight. Boom. Here, tight. Here, tight. Alors, quand tu fais le mouvement, c'est bien, 45, yeah. What comes out is there. L'autre personne, tu vas garder les mains comme tu veux, parce que c'est pas un désarmement. We're not doing it as a disarm, we're doing it as a conditioning. I stay out of the line of fire anyway, and I can rotate that way or that way. That's it. Pas vers le haut. It's not up and down. It's just rotation. I spin up. And so he does his work, and I just give him one direction. You work. Ignore me. Yeah. I test it a little bit. I lean in. Yeah. If he's comfortable, then I do a little bit of that. I see how much weight he puts there. Make sense? We'll just keep punching it up right. Alors maintenant, c'est très important. Tu rallonges pas trop. I want to be above that angle. That's about as far as in. Or close range. Yep. My choice.
That's it. 2 minutes away.
Alors, this one doesn't hurt. Yeah, so this one isn't too bad. So it's all about pain. It's about relaxing. So it's not musculatively hard, it's just pure pain. It's just ton réactivité à douleur. So on your stomach, you can have your gun out. Now you can, you're allowed. Quand on utilise le center axis relax, cette position, c'est pour les endroits restreints. Mais tu peux take spots. Mais l'instant, imagine il y a quelqu'un à la distance de la porte. Somebody at door distance. À cette position-là, c'est encore confortable, mais tu peux faire ton transition à Weaver maintenant. Right now, you can go thumbs forward because there's no danger he's going to get me. Sauf que vous êtes dans une maison pleine de personnes, puis il y a une chance quelqu'un sur un côté ou l'autre pour sauter sur toi. So if I was here all around doors and I was shooting somebody down the hall, I'd probably still stay tight just in case somebody jumped out. Mais dans cet environ, si c'est ouvert, puis j'avais du temps, maintenant tu peux adapter. Right? So what we're going to do now is adapt. So now it's forward push, easy. We're giving you what you wanted the whole time on your belly. Lay down. Keep your gun up. Yeah. Alors, maintenant, tu vas garder une position statique, stable, confortable. Mais tu dois respirer, même s'il y a des inhibitions. If there's a respiratory inhibition, you can still breathe. S'il y a douleur, tu dois changer sans bouger ton fusil. So you can do whatever you want with your body, just don't move your barrel. L'autre personne, tu dois toujours rester perpendiculaire. You must stay perpendicular with your feet. Yeah. So I go here, and I start to work. And I move a little bit, yeah? And he learns just how to absorb it. Dealing with different types of pain. On va rester perpendiculaire parce que on veut pas rentrer entre les vertèbres ou en dessous une omoplate. To his capacity. If you have no balance, don't jump. Stay. And if you're really not comfortable, go on it. If everybody had a George across the USA. Make sense? 2 minutes of that. Enjoy! 20 secondes de réchauffement, on va marcher, tactical walk. Alors, on va baisser, puis on va partager. We're sharing entre les deux jambes. Alors, on veut pas tomber. Right? On veut tirer avec les deux jambes à la main. So we pull, la tête toujours la même hauteur. We don't want a ninja cross. Yeah, I want to be like this. I'm here and I walk. Yeah, simple enough. 20 seconds, everybody, just to see. You don't need a gun. Just show me the walk. Oh. Walk it and walk it and walk it. You need to touch the wall or around the roof. Yes. Right. You fall down. Yes. Right, that's the other person is walking. And your partner just does this. Keep pushing. So pick a focal point anywhere and you switch and you pick your focal point and absorb.
Push, push, push. Come towards the camera, JJ. Oh, yeah.
Sauf que maintenant, tu veux juste mettre compression sur ton fusil. And so we're just going to put pressure on. Try to avoid the pommel if you can, right? C'est pas vraiment le pommel. C'est plus ton main. And so as that gun wants to touch, I try to immediately go onto my wrist. Puis dans cette façon, tu veux minimiser l'affectation. Right? You put the gun down like this, and then as I go to move, it puts tremendous strain on my arm. So you're either going to hurt yourself or have to move, and then in that time you lose sort of precision. So I want to immediately get to an angle, because on the angle, I can move with minimal movement of the weapon, particularly if you're stressed or injured. Right? So don't plant it. A lot of people try to get up like this, but then it's on two things that are not good, elbow, bone, and palm, right on the blade. C'est pas nécessaire quand tu descends que tu divises. You don't have to unscrew. I should get used to feeling this. What you can do as a measurement is you can just get behind your line, front sight, get that front sight level with the back in the center. So I say, am I shooting, for example, that large blue mat over there? And then I look, I say, yep, I'm smack in the center. Or am I shooting manuel? Does it feel, if I'm here and it feels good, and then I don't move my gun and I one eye and I look and I see that I'm hitting the speaker, then I have to calibrate and see where the angle is. But I want to really teach myself to have, you know, relatively comfortable position with small need to move. You can switch hands as you wish.
Maggie!
You alright?
No, I'm just watching you.
Oh, I know.
I do all the time. That's why I have mirrors on my ceiling. Put that in my cat gymnastics.
Of course.
Put them in little unitards.
Pretty.
Awesome. All right, guys, watch what we do now. Maintenant, garde ton fusil confortable. Les deux pieds au sol. So both feet are on the ground. Le seul règlement. Right? If you get to a place you can't solve, the only thing you don't do is lift up a foot. Alors, on lève les pieds jamais. Sont toujours calés au sol. My heels are always on the floor. If I just do this motion, that's how I want them to be. Always on the floor. Maintenant, si on va faire une transition vers un côté, if I roll onto one side, in order for me to pass, I cannot make the bottom side long and the back side short because then I have to go through solid matter. Alors, c'est toujours l'inverse. Le jambe en dessous, put. I bring the bottom leg in and the top leg goes long. Puis maintenant, par les hanches, on divise. I want to stay nice and flat.
Pour retourner, c'est la même chose.
Right, so I can be pointing over my head. Bottom leg comes inside and I stay flat.
Alors, la seule chose qu'on doit faire, idéalement, on ne veut jamais glisser vers un orteil allongé.
Right? Extended toes, I never want to mow over the tip like this. So what I do is I keep the gun behind my foot. Comme ça, tu glisses ton cuisse pour l'équilibre. That's where I want to be. So I'm just going to go back, bicycle transition, onto my back, onto my belly. Nice and low. I'm not going to change the hand, but we see that we could also, from a belly position, I could go with the far side and arrive there. And so I pull myself up as if a cord is pulling my hip. And this way, because my toes are never lifting and I'm never shooting the ground, they should never meet, right? I just want to feel what that feels like. Si vous êtes confortable avec position Weaver, if you find it tiring or you want to use Weaver, it's all right. You can use it. You just try to do this, right? What do we call it when we put our gun in the middle and we shoot off our toes? We call it Tom Cruising.
Right? Yeah.
Collateral. Yeah. Not good.
Let's
do some lights. Turn up. On va juste faire les transitions. I just want to see that I can go from one to two to three. Or if I need to, one to three, three to two. It's my choice. I can move however I want. But I move slowly enough.
Je bouge lentement.
Change ton hauteur si tu veux. Boom! And I just want to see all the time that I'm not shooting off my foot. Just staying slow and low. Comfortable. Making it instinctive. Just want to see how you're comfortable. Alors, si vous êtes droitier, on va garder le fusil dans le côté droit rallongé. We're going to start off with an extended grip. Puis, idéalement, en place d'utiliser les deux, instead of using both in a weaver, we're not going to get too tense, we're just going to keep it floating. Nice and light. C'est flottant, c'est léger, pas trop tendu, but not too tense. Puis, en place d'être en ligne avec le même côté, ça va être avec le diagonal. We want to go with our diagonal eye. Gets better diffusion, better field of vision. Dans cette position, maintenant, on a le main, puis le bras libre. We have a free hand and a free leg. So, at minimum, we're going to do PCPC. I'm going to squat, place my hand down nice and softly. And if I need to, I can just go onto my instep, and I can lay down. This is all I want to see. So then when I come back up, it's nice and comfortable. My hand is floating. If it's comfortable and I don't need my hand, I can keep it ready and I can go right away into this. Yeah. So I want to keep it light as if I'm on cement. I have my gun out. Push. And I start to go down. Hand is out of the way. That's it. So it's my choice. I can put. Hand is there. I can come down. make sure I'm not hitting my head on the floor. It's very comfortable from that position. I can drop right away. Nice look. So this is very good for corner clearance. Si tu veux aller autour d'un coin, par exemple, going around, I start to move, I have to do low line as fast as I need to. Yeah, just as a warm-up. Confi-conf. What we're going to do is we're going to start with the weapon in a close position. Low slung, nice and here, it's on the body, so I can pop up. On va jamais garder le breton. So it's nice and comfortable, as if you could rest there all day long. If you want your second hand there to rest, you rest it. And all we're going to do is take a few steps. So we're just going to run, right? We're going to stop ourselves into a low slide. That's it. Yeah, it's going to be more significant when I start shooting a Maggie. It should be like, yeah. So we're in that position. Weapon's comfortable. I run, and I drop it. Make sure you don't do this. Yeah. Soviet manicure, very painful. Yeah, pedicure, technically, sorry. That's it. At these, same thing. Whoop, we drop and we go. And now we're going to sweep towards the back. 180. Yeah. So we're in position. We're here as we're ready. Ready position. Drop, we're ready. Right away, we go to the back. Nice and steady. Diffuse your eyes. That's it. What we're going to do is we're going to just put it into the menton, keep it into the belt, yeah. Tout le monde ici. We're just going to stay on the smooth side, a little bit easier for you, then we can move over to the combat appellation. Come on over, don't be shy. So this is all we do, guys. Hands flip up. On peut faire deux ou trois lignes en même temps. They flip up, face goes to the side, right? That's our first action. Deuxième, on commence, on veut pencher. We always want to carry, if you have a pistol carry, carry it in front, don't carry it in the back, don't carry it inside. Dans ton ligne ici, it's called appendix carry. Tons of studies have come out to show that retention and access are much faster. The Starsky and Hutch carry in the back, very slow, very bad. Yeah. So I keep it in front, nice and comfortable, and all I want to do is turn my face and bring my hands up. Right? So it's that. And then maintenant, c'est pas juste un squat. If you start to squat at a muscular level, we generally reach our limit and then have to go forward, and the back is quite strong. That's it, il y a beaucoup de strain dans ton dos. Avec l'arme à feu, tu vas sentir un blocage aussi. Right? So it's really this. I start bending. As my face goes to the side, hand comes up. And then, in that position, my hands are ready. Hands go down, faces to the side. That's the first action I want, yeah? Dans cette position, maintenant, voir si tu peux soulever tes coudes. I'd like to keep my elbows off the ground for a moment. We do our as much as we want, as slow as we want. Here. Puis dans cette position, I'm just going to move slow. I'm going to stay high at first. We're going to go low soon. Yeah? How fast we go, it just matters how slow and low. Okay, so I want to get down, and now from this position, I want to stay as flat as I can. Yeah? Like they're strafing gunfire, barbed wire, stuff. Yeah, low, low seat. So we're going to start by a low, 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 low squat. As low as we can, keep the pistol in one hand, nice and comfortable. In this position, dans cette position, maintenant je vais mettre le deuxième main au sol, puis c'est le même vis, right? The same screw. Je vais visser, puis je vais tomber avec le genou à l'intérieur de mon pied. Le main en arrière, c'est toujours un vis, right? So I screw up. First position is a shin box, c'est un bois de tibia. Puis si tu utilises cette vis, on peut dépasser pour un squat. A nice low farmer squat. So that's it. I find a nice, comfortable resting position. Yeah? Si vous êtes vraiment confortable, tu peux faire le vis aussi. Avec le deuxième main. Sometimes you don't have a choice. So I see now. If I can use that. Immediately get in the position.
The other side with the gun. No, but the gun on the ground.
Okay. Hey guys, dans cette position maintenant, on va faire une transition en stance de chasseur. So hunter squat. Imagine ton pied, on a les quatre orteils, c'est une surface, puis le grand orteil, c'est un deuxième. So I have that. First surface created by the outer four toes, and then I have the large toe. On ne veut jamais faire un transition direct sur le grand orteil. I never go over the big toe, right? So I'm going to flip over the small toes. and I screw. So really, my big toe never really makes contact. Imagine l'ombre sur ton grand orteil, ça va presque jamais toucher. And I screw. Pour dévisser, prendre un pas, I take a bigger step, faire une transition, enlève tous les poids, puis dévisse. Doesn't matter what side I do. This is a much more comfortable resting position. If you found yourself, you know, squatting quickly and then you realize you're gonna have to stay there for a little bit. Most people, especially in the West, they hold this for, if they have, can hold this, they after about 5-10 minutes, they start to fatigue a lot. Si jamais tu peux rester dans cette position, tu vas voir. C'est environ 8 à 10 minutes, tu vas fatiguer. People start to shift, get uncomfortable. So at that point, if I shift into 100 squat, it's much more comfortable. If it's wet or cold, I'm protected. Protéger si jamais vous êtes dans la forêt. That's why it's called the hunter squat. You can hold this a long time. And you always have the other side. If you get tired, you can move, you can eat, balance your bay leaf, eat your larva, whatever it is. Don't judge. It's all right. We'll relax. Maintenant, on va faire l'enchaînement Kazakh leg screws. So just go with me by the numbers. On va commencer dans le squat bas. So we go into a low squat. Puis on doit arriver dans un bois de tibia. I have to get into a shin box. Alors, de façon le moins stressante, c'est de tomber. Fall into my shin box. Yeah? Dans cette position, lève la torse. I take my body up. Avec le mets ou non, vis dans un. Ça, on touche à ça. I just sit on up and do a half kneeling, 100 squat. That's it. Beautiful. Dans cette position, maintenant, je vais avancer. Alors, prendre un pas. I take a little step. Puis, on veut faire une transition sur les orteils. I'm going to take my heel off the ground. Il n'y a aucune pression sur le fesse, sur le jambe ici. Et maintenant, tu peux faire un pivot. I can pivot here. Si tu dois rester complètement ouvert, right? If I have to stay like this, that's fine. It's considered open Kazakh or open Russian squat. Si tu peux, asseoir sur le talon. Ça, c'est vraiment un squat Kazakh pur. Right? We talk about a Kazakh or a Russian squat. That's a pure Russian squat right there. That's what I'd like to have. Yeah? Those are the only three positions I need. So we're going to fall again. Shin box. When I screw up, even if I have the capacity, même si vous êtes capable, normalement on ne veut pas visser dans la position Kazakh parce que des fois, tu vas cramper, ça peut déchirer, le stress, ça peut être trop soulevé. It's very tough on the tendon. So I generally always transition onto my hunter and then use the elasticity. Il y a une élasticité ici, je vais faire une transition à Kazakh, right? Si ça doit être plus ouvert, c'est correct. Think of a dance, right? It's like that. Then I can come back up. Alors maintenant, idéal, tu peux utiliser le main libre, I can use it to go shin box, hunter, Kazakh, mais tu peux faire aussi sans les mains. So, I fall, shin box, get those toes under, and sit on up and go hunter. Avance, enlève le poids. So just to feel it, we're just going to have our pistol in a low, comfortable position. Partner goes behind us. And at this point, forget about shoot, no shoot. You're just going to have the weapon on you. And you don't even want to worry about fighting it. You feel like somebody's, you know, checking and asking you to get up. They think you're unarmed. All we want to not do is this. Go more into the line of fire. Because he doesn't even have to move, right? And it's comfortable for him. Alors, idéalement, je vais aller au sol ici. I'd like to go to the ground here. Underneath. Make sense? You have the half second. So this way, what happens is as soon as you feel a push, right? I go right away into that position. And I look for up the face. Quelques fois, puis change. No! Ball shot! You wish you're going to drop using the same tactic, right? So that's going to be the push. Hey, yeah, that's the shit. Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Alors, le sujet ce soir, c'est les armes d'opportunité. So, we're going to do improvised weapon tonight. Mais normalement, quand on fait ça, on utilise des choses moins orthodoxes comme les stylos, les livres, les ceintures. Right? So, normally, we do stuff like baseball caps, and frying pans, umbrellas, whatever. Mais ce soir, on va faire des choses plus évidentes, peut-être, ou things that are a little bit more obvious or that are already weapons. Les couteaux de cuisine, kitchen knives, that's a good one. Scissors, linoleum knife. Linoleum, des marteaux, hammers, des haches, axes, which are the favorite, cleavers, how do you say cleaver in French?
Hache.
All right. Couclis, which is couclis, puis des pelles militaires, right? Une trenching tool. Puis dans chacun, parce que c'est un peu évident, souvent, sont mal utilisés. Because it's so obvious people use them wrongly, and everybody ends up looking like some girl in a horror film. You know? Oh, very desperate. Which is just not a good look. Alors, on va faire juste des. On va donner des contextes. Puis, la chose importante, on a un grand choix. Alors, tout le monde va être armé, mais tu dois changer les armes souvent. I'd like you to change. I only made one pair of scissors, one pair of linoleum, but we want to get into it. Alors, la première chose, on va faire. Very, very simple. First thing. Imagine vous êtes dans un contexte, ça peut être dans ton maison ou n'importe où, right? Depending on what the context is, I have one of these by my bed. But imagine you're coming up behind somebody. Vous êtes dans une situation, c'est très évident. Tu dois éliminer quelqu'un. You want to take somebody out, maximum lethal force, complètement mortel, si fort que possible. Puis tu as ton arme. Right? On a besoin d'une connaissance de la capacité de chaque arme, puis la façon dont tu peux mettre quelqu'un au sol complètement immédiatement. Right? So you just want to be able to take somebody down. Alors, avec un pelle militaire, pour un military shovel, c'est très lourd, c'est très heavy. So if you did want to be non-lethal, si tu veux éviter des choses qui sont certainement mortelles, un grand coup sur l'extérieur de la tête, sur le crâne, ça peut marcher. It's a good possibility the guy will go down. Mais il y a toujours une chance, ça ne va pas marcher. But I always give the chance, the thing I saw as a bouncer, I saw somebody take a baseball bat to the neck. J'ai vu quelqu'un, il a pris un bâton à baseball dans l'aluminium sur le nuque. Plein de force. Guy ran across the parlor. Ouais! Like that. Just because of anger, not because of your good neck, but nothing else. Alors, si tu veux tuer quelqu'un, and you're looking for high probability, tout le dos, les jambes, les bras, pas de tout utile. You hit somebody with that, even if it's sharp, c'est certain si c'est ton pelle, tu peux aiguiser le pelle bien, right? You can, the one I have at home is so sharp, you can shave with it, right? Even then, if I hit you on the back, what's it going to do? Ça peut briser des côtes, ça peut rentrer peut-être dans ton poumon. S'il y a une deuxième personne, tu veux crier. The second person, you're screaming, you're not dying right away. Si tu as un couteau, you have one side that still works, you have a gun, I'm fucked, right? So I want to get you, I'm looking for the nape, right? Dans les plupart des cas, ça va être le base de le nuque, base de la cerveau, right, the brain stem. Puis si on frappe, if I just turn your back, if we imagine coming up behind somebody, because that's natural, and I do this, it's hard for me to access there, right? Alors je veux chercher un diagonal au minimum ou un coup horizontal. So if I'm not as tall, it's not going to be comfortable to go horizontal. If I am taller, I can go horizontal. Ideally, I'd like to get here, right? Dans tous les cas, l'anatomie nécessaire pour ce soir, on a C1, C2 ici. Right? Cervical arch 1 and 2, vertebrae is right here. If you pierce that, it's high probability of immediate death, right? C'est mortel. 3, 4 et 5, c'est plus paralysé. C'est possible, c'est mortel, mais c'est probable qu'il ne va pas battre. It's possible he's not going to cut. But with a shovel, to do that, low probability. Hack here, right? C'est possible, il va perdre connaissance, c'est moins probable que tu vas rentrer. Alors, on doit chercher un coup relativement horizontal. I'd like to cleave between the vertebrae. Si c'est sur le côté, ça marche aussi sur l'artère, parce que tu vas frapper les vertèbres aussi, right? I'll get a good cut. Or if it's in front, right, and again. Idéalement, tu peux blesser le gars si vite que possible, puis arrêter la capacité de crier. Right? So if you have shovel, that's what I'm looking for. And I want to get that good aim, get used to it. Si c'est un couteau de cuisine, right, a kitchen knife, est-ce qu'on sont vraiment stable dans les plupart des cas? Right? Most people have really, really solid kitchen knives. Absolutely not. Right? Go home, look at your kitchen knife. Very thin. Right? They snap very easily. Imagine sur un morceau du bois. Est-ce que tu penses que tu peux faire un push-up avec deux? Can you? Do you think you'd be strong enough to do it? Even with your thumb on top, there's a good chance that's going to come up. So this notion that you're going to go like that, not so good. Right? C'est certain, si tu veux percer, if you are going to pierce, puis tu as l'auteur, prendre la bouche, puis on va chercher l'intérieur de son clavicule. I want to go inside the clavicle, here, because now I'm going to get subclavian artery and lung, right? Puis tu vas rentrer, puis trancher. So that's what I'm looking to do, right? I'm looking to come up, in, and deep, and it's going to like this, like a joystick, right? But if I did want to take somebody down, what's the highest probability? Is this good for stabbing the back? It's huge and it's thin, they snap, right? So that's your best, if you're going to go here. Now, what's the danger? Alors, quand tu rentres, fais pas un grand technique. If you are going to cut, it's better to come up on the top if you can, right? Or if not, if I am pulling, push. And try to limit yourself, because it's less likely you'll go like this. Si on fait un grand mouvement, tu peux couper ton bras. That happens all the time. That's why the military moved away from that. Scissors. Good pair of industrial scissors. What am I going to use? Est-ce que c'est bon dans cette façon? C'est presque, comme un carambit, c'est presque toujours un pic à glace. And so if you have scissors, you can put your finger in. Normally, it's far side. And I use it like that, even a small pair. That's the best way. If I try to hold it like this, the hole doesn't help me. I can get brain, or brain step, or a subclavian. I can go into the lung, I can get into the back sometimes, it'll go deep, right? Comme un tournevis, ça rentre facilement. A simple screwdriver, $1 screwdriver, you're more likely to get the heart or the lung. Just right into the body. Pull force, yeah? Linoleum knife. It's because I like them. Same thing. Throw, try and cut. Again, it's better to rock forward and rip. Un marteau. Quand tu prends le marteau, si vous êtes très bas, if you're very, very low, tu as toute la puissance possible, mais la rétention, c'est pas bon, puis la précision, c'est pas bon. Alors, comme un hache, like an axe, right? When I hit, hammer's about the only weapon I can hit straight with. Avec un marteau, tu peux faire vertical. So if you're not comfortable cutting somebody, you pick these up, and even with this, you're like, feels gross, that's your weapon of choice. Right to the brainstem. Boom, right? Anywhere on the head is bad. Two hands if you need it. So if you're not comfortable with one hand coming up and you don't feel strong enough, puis on a un vrai marteau là, si jamais tu veux utiliser, we have the real shovel, the real hammer if you want to just feel the difference, right? But if I grab it, that's the easiest way. Grab nice and low, especially smaller people. Second hand on top. This is okay, but this is more likely. And just pow, right in. Wow, straight to the brain. Very good. Don't get fancy. You can do this if you want. Les griffes, right? Tu peux, c'est correct, mais c'est pas précis. You're not doing something precise. You're going, whoom, right? Concussive shot. Un hache, c'est presque la même chose, mais ça doit être un peu diagonal. Axes, I want to go diagonal again, so I can double up my hand or hold just a little bit higher. Right? On dit, on veut entraîner le ventre. So choke the base, have a little palm on, and I'm going right into the base as much as I can. Yeah? Hachette,
is that what it is?
Hachette. Same thing, right? Horizontal, right? Not vertical, parce que ça va juste briser son clavicule. Puis le kukri, kukri is basically a knife and an axe together. C'est une machette népalaise. C'est très, très efficace, c'est très lourd, mais c'est pas vraiment utile pour percer. It's not so great for stabbing. Il n'y a aucun avantage de faire inversion. If you ever have a real one, they're so fucking heavy. They're not, even when they're sharp, the shape is not good for that. The shape is meant to contour. Alors, c'est comme un hache. So it's meant to hack and slice. That's what it's for. So this again is you going back of the skull. Like this. Alors, prends l'outil tu veux, tout le monde avec un. Everybody with one. Ton sujet, il va être debout. Puis on va juste pratiquer comment tu peux rentrer. I just want to get used to coming to the back of the brain. Dans tous les cas, c'est le nuque. Change. Continuellement. On va faire face à face. Mais c'est mieux garder un grand distance. Right? Keep an excessive distance so there's no danger. In case you slip or whatever. Allez, c'est chose, on va faire un grand concentration maintenant sur vitesse. Right now you're in front of somebody and you have to be fast. Et les armes qu'on a des fois sont pas naturellement vite. Right? A lot of the things we have are naturally fast. Alors, je vais donner juste le premier concept. First idea, on va garder une position orthodoxe. Nothing changes, or just to start. Mais on va juste voir si jamais tu travailles avec ton arme et c'est pas confortable. You see it's not that comfortable, donne juste un peu plus de pommeau, a little bit of higher pommel, to the extent that, pas complètement, I don't want to go completely, mais à la capacité d'aller vers le centre. Right? Clearly, you don't really have a choice, but if it's an axe or something that's a lever weapon, where you have a lot of loss, at least go up two finger widths, le minimum de distance de deux droites, ou jusqu'à le centre, right up to about the center point, usually about 45% up, right? And I see now if it feels faster, but I want to see what my fastest shot is. Vous voyez pas, c'est plus léger. It's much, much, much lighter. Alors, dans la réalité, il y a certaines choses qu'on va faire maintenant qui ne vont pas marcher, mais on va voir dans 5 minutes. For now, I just want to get up there, see what my speed is. Look for my fastest shot, where it would be the face, bridge of the nose, side of the neck, boom, right to the throat. Fastest shot. Alors, c'est juste une question de vitesse. Tu vas garder rien dans ton réserve maintenant, right? Don't hold back. In my brain, that was fast. I want you to get there and boom, twitch it as fast as you fucking can, yeah? So I'll only say that once. Si vite que tu peux. You're not going to feel it. Let's try. Okay, guys, so watch now. C'est ton choix. Dans tous les cas, si vite que possible, as fast as I can.
Dans tous les cas, une bonne racine. I want to have a good base in every case. Maintenant, tu vas voir si tu veux travailler comme un fouet. Do you want to work like a whip? Il y a des choses qui sont très bonnes avec un fouet. Right? Think of a finger whip. Finger whip will never be faster like this. Si on fait un 8 avec un doigt, avec les doigts, ça va être jamais si vite que ça. Never. You'll never see anybody on Jeopardy doing this. Never. It's always pop, pop, as fast as you can be. So with a finger, that's very, very simple. Avec un coup sec, c'est la même chose. Comme ça, c'est jamais si vite que ça. Right? Because as soon as I start to put an arc in it, it gets a little slow. Alors avec un H, par exemple, c'est une question de préférence. It's preference now. If I can handle the weight, si c'est pas trop pour moi, peut-être un fouet direct où ça va retourner sur le même bois, c'est confortable. If I have the power, right? Some people will work like this. Some people will work like this, avec le pouce ou non. C'est ton choix. But if I'm here, it's my choice. Do I go here? Avec ça, par exemple, ici, c'est très confortable pour retourner. If I return, straight path, no problem. If I choke right at the bottom, it starts to change. Si je vais prendre maintenant un vrai marteau, I take a real hammer, it's different, hein? Boom! If, oh, see what happens? It starts to come out of my grip right away. Right? Alors maintenant, le deuxième choix, c'est un fouet qui va faire une rotation. Right? So, and then I come back. Alors, la concentration, c'est moins le premier coup, plus l'absorption. Just come like nunchucks. Nunchucks, you cannot work like this. Bad things happen. Tu dois fouetter puis absorber. That's why they rotate. You have to. So I have to hit and then absorb. Yeah. Have to. There's no choice. This, always do that. Always. It has to be like that. Et en plus, quand tu frappes quelque chose, ça va retourner vers toi. As soon as I hit something, right, it's going to come right back to me. So I have to absorb. There's no choice. Has to be. C'est pas une question d'opinion. Avec un H, c'est ton choix. Avec un marteau, there's not really that many people are going to be that strong here. So it has to go out and absorb. Out and absorb. Out and absorb. Does that make sense? Decide maintenant. With your tool, decide. Prendre un bâton baseball, right? Quand tu frappes vers le centre, on roule. Right? We roll. Make sense? So now you take your second hand off. We roll. So when I go backwards, on va rouler ici. L'instant, ça va barrer, right? It wants to lock out. That's just there where I roll. Pour garder la flexion. Maintenant, enlève ton doigt, premier doigt, puis ton pouce. C'est les trois en dessous qui vont garder la compression. So I see now, I never want to do this. Right? So right away I hit. Maintenant, j'ai ton pouce ici, I put my thumb. I feel it right away. Ton premier doigt, c'est juste une direction. Si on parle d'un bâton, par exemple, take a basic stick. Il y a des styles qui travaillent avec des bâtons de 18 à 20 pouces. Right? Some styles will work with 18 to 20-inch sticks, particulièrement l'escrime cabalis escrima, because he's a midget, he's a small dude. Mais à cause de ça, il va tenir normalement le bâton si bas que possible, des fois avec un petit doigt en dessous. They'll sometimes put the small finger underneath and work that way. Avec un bâton de cette longueur, 24 à 26 pouces, c'est pas possible. Right? Even at this length, I put my finger under there, it's not going to work. Alors, l'instant on a un bâton environ 2 pieds ou plus, on a besoin d'un pommeau. Right? Ou les Philippines, dans les Philippines, on dit un pugno ou un pommel. Puis environ, c'est minimum de 2 doigts ou la distance d'un main. Normally, in Cali, you're looking for at least one hand distance, because that permits counterbalance, right? C'est certain, tu peux attraper avec le bout, tu peux frapper avec le bout, mais plus que ça, tu peux glisser. Right? Yes, you can trap. Yes, you can hit. But it's about permitting slippage, because that happens with sweat and blood and vomit and everything else good in a fight. Mais plus que ça, ça va donner un contrebalance. Right? Si le bâton est un peu large vers le bout, if you have a fluted stick, like a pirate truncheon, dans tous les cas, tu vas avoir un cord. Right? They'll put a cord on the end for retention. That's the reason it's there, right? Si tu travailles comme un couteau ou un épi arabique, you look at like an Arabic scimitar or like some of the Russian-style Cossack knives and kinjals.
Is that what it is, Nikolai?
Kinjal, yeah. A kinjal or a shashka. They always have, at minimum, au minimum, tu vas avoir ça. Un pommeau un peu curvé, parce que la torque, à cause de cette arc, because of the arc, the curve, there's more sort of whip at the end of it. So you need to have that counter hook, right? Ou tu vas avoir plus comme des épis... I don't want to say a cutlass, but European or European swords, Civil War swords, you'll have a handguard pour rétention. It helps retention, puis en plus, ça va protéger ton main. Quand tu as un épi chrétien, you take a Christian sword, c'est comme un longueur standard pour un épi avec un main, but a one-handed sword is always like this. C'est certains sont toujours basés sur une forme de crucifix, right? It's always a cruciform for Jesus, that's the whole reason they did it that way. Mais la chose importante, c'est le pommeau. You'll always see giant balls on the end. Why? C'est contrebalance, sinon tu ne peux pas travailler avec l'arme. Si c'est beaucoup plus lourd, tu as besoin d'un contrebalance beaucoup plus lourd, right? If it's not... It's all on the tip, and you don't have anything counterbalance, you can't swing it. Puis ça, c'est minimum, right? Tu parles d'un épi standard, c'est environ 2,5 à 3 pieds. It's already getting longer than a katana. C'est environ 4 fois le poids. Right? Alors, imagine avec un main. Katana is being used with two hands for sliding. You have something like that. Tu as des épis de 6 pieds, mais claymores are 6 feet long. Two-handed or a bastard sword is 1.5 hands. Bastard sword. Oh, bastards. So you have to have that big counterbalance. You have to. Sinon, ça marche pas. Puis finalement, tu l'as comme des I don't say a mace. You know, mace, right? Normalement, sont un main avec un corde. Sinon, tu dois garder le main plus haut ou tu vas travailler avec deux mains. A lot of maces are meant to be held with two hands, Mohican clubs, things like that, right? Tu as besoin de deux mains. Alors, quand tu viens à des autres armes, on a le choix maintenant. So we start to get the other weapons. I'm going to take you, just to show you. Mate, let me see. Come on up! Come on up! $4 hammer sharpened with my wit, right? Just hold it like a hammer. There you go. All right, so just very lightly flick it and see what that feels like. Right? It's very hard, right? Des fois, tu penses que tu vas vite avec un marteau, mais c'est pas vraiment confortable. Alors, si je suis dans cette situation, vous êtes silent, puis tu veux me tuer complètement. Right? So she knows she just wants to fucking put me down as hard as she can. It's your Conan moment. One or two hands. Ah! No problem. Mais aussi, on est face à face. Maintenant, c'est dépendant sur vitesse. You go, I come in, I get you on the ground, I start punching the face. Si vous êtes trop tard, bouffez pour moi. Yeah? That's the simple reality. So try, you see, it doesn't feel comfortable at all, right? Even if you choke it, right? Still not, doesn't feel that fast, right? So, une bonne chose avec un marteau, you can try it after. Tu vas inverter le marteau. Mais souvent, les personnes vont faire l'inversion, mais ils vont garder les griffes à l'intérieur. You see, there's no real comfortable way to go low, right? It fucks you up, it's no good. So we grab it like this, punch it right up, watch it, all the way down. Yep. Yep. Like this, nice and comfortable. Whip it. That's pow. Yeah, it's comfortable. Sur la rétention, tu peux être plus flexible maintenant parce que tu as un crochet juste comme un scimitar, right? Just like an Arabic scimitar, gives you that, right? Mets le marteau, imagine you just tap a hand. Boom, done, right? That's a true hammer fist. Very good. Pete, it's pretty good. Yeah, and you can cut with that. So this, you got a hammer. If you're working with a hammer, imagine on a trois distances, right? We have three basic grips. That's my, I'm going to knock you out. Nobody's in the room. I'm walking up behind you. Second hammer, I go, boom. Doesn't matter, right? On est face à face, on veut travailler. Maintenant, ça va être plus ici. Grab it. There's a bulb here for a reason, right? Pour un clou, c'est certain, si vous êtes confortable, tu vas aller bas. Les personnes qui ne sont pas expérimentées, vont aller là naturellement. Even nails, right? Somebody who's not comfortable with a hammer will choke it. So if you can't nail in a nail with full extension, you're not going to fight with full extension. It's fucking impossible. So if you put in nails, you bend nails all the time, that's where you hold it. I'm telling you now. The bent nails have told you, choke it in the middle. Mais même là, c'est pas vite. Alors quand tu dois faire le changement, c'est les griffes en avant. It's a $4 hammer. I checked at the dollar store today. Trois pièces. Dollar store. Solid steel hammer. $3. Yeah? So, just grip like this. So now I have the speed. That's as fast as you can make that hammer. Then when I get inside, I can start to work. Quand on travaille avec un pelle militaire. Yeah. All right, so how fast do you think you get it? How high would you want to choke it to be fast with that?
Here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're going to either go really high, inversion. So when you invert it, see, the Soviet shovel is always curved like that for a reason, so it doesn't cut your hand. Maintenant, tu peux utiliser le pelle ici pour protéger les artères avec un shield. Ding, right? I can flick, right? And that's going to be faster a little bit there. Does that make sense? Kukri, same thing, right? Think of flicking. Not so comfortable. Alors, quand tu as le kukri, normalement, on veut travailler juste comme le pelle. En place de faire un fouet, on veut faire un angle, right? It's like a ramp. Don't think of stabbing. Neither this nor that is that good for stabbing. Good for hacking, but it's not fast. Alors, tu veux vraiment juste chercher l'angle. I just go past, right? It's the same thing with kukri. If you ever study like Bando or Silat, when you use the kukri, that's your base position for jab. And you don't ever, you're not really thinking of this, you're thinking of that. Because it drags the body like a snowplow. Right? Puis quand tu dépasses, chouk, comes back net parce que tu veux pousser contre cet axe, or you're pushing against the axis. So when you go past it, you jump and you hook. So you get cut. That's what it's for. Not just because it looks good, right? C'est très bon pour un hache aussi. Mais quand tu rentres, si tu veux vitesse, c'est plus ici. A little bit on angle. And you slide it. That's your fastest shot with that. No advantage out of inverting. Si tu penses inversion est bon, même si c'est aiguisé, whatever you could do with this, you could do with this way more comfortably. C'est comme un katana. C'est très bon dans les films de samouraï ou ninja, comme ça, right? Mais quand c'est proche, c'est là. If it's that sharp that you can cut inverted, you can cut, why would you fuck up your shape? It looks cool, à part de ça, c'est plus bon ici. I just want to keep it. So, we're just going to look now. With shovel, it's your choice. Shovel is meant to be used, the Russian shovel is meant to be used this way. Alors, si tu veux, tu peux travailler comme ça, c'est un fouet. Juste faire attention, fais-le quelques fois avec celle-là pour être certain. Tu veux jamais mettre le côté vers ton bras. I never want to put that, just because it's not comfortable. Ça va être jamais aiguisé ici, c'est juste pas confortable. That's what that's for. For gripping, yeah. If you want, or here, right? And then I can work. If I don't like it, I can go here. That's fine, right? But choke it high if you're going to be fast, parce que maintenant, c'est un contrebalance. I want to be sharp, right? Kukri, that's going to be faster. Sinon, puis on dépasse, right? Mais on perd pas. Don't ever do this. That's come feel it slowly so you understand where it goes. Un marteau, mon opinion, toujours comme ça, pour vitesse. If I'm in front of you and I've got a hammer, you've got a knife, I'm not going to duel with that position. Contre une arme de vitesse, fusil, couteau, n'importe quoi, je vais changer immédiatement. And so I teach myself, that's where I'm going to be in my fighting position, I switch. Right? La même chose avec un hache. Axe, it's your choice. Right? Here is not a fast position. Tu as le choix, si c'est confortable, on peut fouetter comme ça. I can launch, ou ici. I can work, but usually it's going to be that. On peut aller comme ça, if your arm is strong enough, you can work here, ou ici, mais tu peux changer aussi. And then that's fast. Now I have speed, and I can cut, tu peux couper, tu peux frapper. Alors maintenant, quand je dis vitesse, pense de vitesse, right? I want you to think of how fast. You're in a duel, puis même ça, right? This is just a little piece of hollow wood. Parce que le pommeau est lourd, des fois on pense c'est pas fort. You think it's not hard, but you take something like this, and you go, fuck, it's so light. What would that do? Just tap. Or go here. If that hurts, boom, eye socket cracked. So, anytime, come up, calibrate, feel it. Sentir la différence. Si tu veux sentir un vrai kukri militaire, feel the kukri over there, it's fucking heavy. That's how this happened. And I was doing a lot of work with kukri. It's like, ugh. It really works the wrist. So you want to make sure that you have a fast weapon and you have a hard. Tu dois savoir ton coup de puissance puis ton coup de vitesse, sans doute. You don't have time. It's very simple. All that other fancy shit inversion, it's cool to play, but you're going to die. You need to keep it simple. I have a hammer, I'm going to go like that. I get you down. Take your ribs open. Yeah? Make sense? Keep going. That was your head switch. Switch your... We're going to continue into the next stage of it. So now, instead of working speed with this, we're going to put it back, puis on va faire le fouet avec les mains en avant. Right? Without any training, le fouet ici, pas du tout complexe. Right? It's not at all complicated. It sounds funny. On veut juste éviter, parce que des fois, quand on fait ma boxe, on croise. Right? Some people box like this. Puis quand tu sors, c'est proche de ton main. Maintenant, peut-être tu vas voir. This is happening. This, you might recognize right away. So keep it up. Tight to the face, tight to the neck, wherever you want. Quand tu lances ton coussin, commence haut. If you just start high, keep your hands high, you avoid the problem. But if you have that habit, make sure they each have their own lane. Right? Idéalement, on veut pivoter pour rallonger. We have pivot as far as we can, or we jump it. Right? But maintenant, après, pense de ton coup de puissance. If I was working with my free hand as a whip, would I keep it like this? Ça, c'est juste pour les coups secs. Alors, si tu vas faire ton coup sec avec l'autre main, naturellement, ici, je peux travailler pour crochet ou des entraînements, les attaques proches, right? Come up and start to work. Make sense? Oui, le fouet avec le main libre. Honey, thanks. Je vais laisser un dernier concept pour la dernière 10 minutes. I'm going to give you one last idea. So, est-ce que tu veux garder l'arme en avant ou en arrière? It's your choice. You want to have a front or a back. Il y a des histoires, right? Il y a des écoles complètement différentes. Some people are like, it's like a religion, right? This is a fencing grip. Alors, c'est si tu l'aimes vitesse, les avantages, right? L'avantage, c'est la distance. You have length, distance. Des fois, vitesse, and speed. Si si tu aimes la boxe purement puis tu détestes la lutte, probablement ça c'est bon pour toi. If you really love fencing, legs, and you're very fast with your lead and you never want to clinch, I would say do this. Si tu as le réflexe de compresser la distance, if you feel better going in, I would say keep it back. Mais quand tu gardes l'arme en arrière, maintenant tu peux protéger ton corps plus, on va chercher moins. Right? So when you're in front, you're almost naturally, you're going to start to reach. Tu vas chercher plus, tu vas donner plus de ton corps. Alors si vous n'êtes pas vite avec cet outil, if you're not fast with the weapon, because you can be fast without it, I wouldn't put it in front. Quand vous êtes en arrière, un concept que tu peux jouer avec, c'est un lead twisted, right? Twisted or modified lead. It looks like this. My right side is back. Le pied droit en arrière. L'hanche droite en avant. Right foot is back. Right hip is forward. It's called the twisted lead. That means my back hip and back shoulder have to be more forward. Capoeira uses that as a basic concept for switching. Right? You see that, but you see that in Cali. Kitty Tercy when they trap. Tout basé sur ça. La torque dans ton corps, c'est déjà présent. Sur la vitesse, right? And your idea is that you have to get to a position. You just put a hand up in space. Alors, je dois chercher la distance optimale. Crazy, right? Look, watch my feet. With my hand, I'm not going to reach, right? With my weapon, that's my maximum distance I can get. Look, I'm going to push it right to my max, right? And I'm already losing structure. Comfortably, that's where I'd want to be. No movements. Look at my feet. It's a perception that it's shorter. Right? Test it. Go try it out. Parce que si vous êtes comme un ressort, right? You're like a spring. So you actually, wham, you have more power. Si tu veux travailler avec un ce type de puissance, ou tu veux travailler vers l'intérieur, Bagua, they use that kind of energy all the time. Rear-handed jab. Chinese styles use this a lot. Cali uses a lot. And then, weapon on weapon, as I start moving out, I'm giving the outside. So if he comes in, now I'm more likely to come here. So the clash and come up. Si on pense des défenses, tu fais ce type de défense rétractée, ça marche pas bien, right? In order for this to do anything, my backhand, my check, I have to have a twisted lead to come up. Même chose pour les projections. If I always fight like this, it's very easy to see. But if I can pull my hip back without moving my feet, it's hidden, it's fast, and then I need it. I'll see the movement dans les poches. So it's definitely an advanced concept, reverse torque, but I see. I can, a lot of guys will work this way. You'll see it in fencing, right? Going back 1,000 years. Alors, c'est ton choix. You want to keep it in front? Make sure you have speed with a number of things. Tu dois être vite avec plusieurs outils. Si tu veux garder ça en arrière, c'est correct. Comme ça, tu peux faire le fouet avec l'autre main. Venus flytrap. Bam, 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 bam. C'est beau. Mais si tu peux être vite avec les deux, maintenant c'est bien. 8 minutes, ton choix. Jouer, jouer. Alors, pour défense contre les fusils, for defense against the gun, on va faire 10 minutes avec des armes. We're just going to continue to float together. Après ça, on va faire une application avec les mains nues. We're going to do some basic empty hand stuff. Puis idéalement, cette arme, ça va donner une sensitivité, une nouvelle perception. Maybe it'll be a new way of working. Puis on va utiliser des armes juste parce que ça ajoute une complexité. Right? It adds a complexity right away. Alors, il y a une demande qu'on élimine la complexité dans les mouvements. Right? We have to simplify our movements and not get all fucking... Crazy. So this is all I want us to do. On va commencer contre quelqu'un statique. Très simple. Rentre comme un robot. Right? Like this. All I want you to do is this. Le main libre, adresse le main immédiatement. Alors, si vous êtes droitier contre un droite, you're right against right, I don't want us to do this. Parce que ça donne aucune contrôle. You can do stuff, your brain becomes very fancy. And I don't want us to do this. Right? So if I want to literally come in like this, j'avais deux choix. Ça ou ça. Those are my only two options. What determines what I take, il y a juste un qui va être bon, dépendant sur ton arme. Si quand tu arrives à la première distance, ton main libre est en ligne avec son main, on travaille là. So my free hand lines up, awesome. If I come here and my free hand does not line up with the hand, my computer goes, and then I go here. Make sense? I want it that simple. Puis dans cette position, la position que tu veux, right, I can take this or this, it's my choice. Right. Normally, I like to control the thumb. Maintenant, je vais voir qu'est-ce que je peux faire. Right. I can go here, here, here. My choice. I don't care if it's... Ta! Hein? Ra! 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 Depends on your weapon. Pa, pa, pa. Yeah? If It's here. It doesn't have to be fancy. Just be careful. Don't get fancy. If I start doing this, that's not good. Yeah? Anything I do has to bring it right into him. So it can be as simple as this, right? I don't want anything fancy. My choice. Right? So get in. Empty hand is on there. And then I start to work however I can. C'est ton choix si tu veux changer le mais ou non. S'il veut changer le mais ou non, quelquefois, change les ans. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah, that's it.
C'est complexe, right? It's excessive, it's complex, but when's it going to happen? You never know. Mais maintenant, on va retourner des désarmements. On va juste appliquer le même règlement. Right? If I'm here, I work. Maintenant, j'avais les deux bras. Right? So I'm either going to be here or here. And then the other hand comes in just like it did with the weapon, right? I'm either going to be here or here, and I work. Right? Le même chose. Change les armements immédiatement. Regarde dans le fusil. Switch. Voilà, c'est simple.
Be nice and simple. Don't cross your arm. Start snaking around. Hey guys, watch what we add now. Many of you know this. Alors, quand on prend le fusil, on veut bouger le bout. Comme un triangle isocèle, c'est un isosceles triangle. So we have a baseline, un pli de 90 degrés, 90 degree bend. Tip. On the plane of flexion, sur le plan sur lequel tu bouges, tu vas aller directement vers son coude. Rubber knife, rubber gun, he's holding pretty strongly. I go here, wrong. See what happens? He holds on. I go here, a bit better, but still hanging on. I want to go right to the elbow. Like I'm trying to hit it. C'est comme tu veux frapper. Idéalement, on veut utiliser le poignet. I want to work here, and it's the hip. Flexion, rétraction. That's what I want. Si tu vas vers le haut, faire attention que le doigt c'est pas dans le gâchette puis tu gardes pas son doigt sur le front. Careful about these. I never move the line of fire to me. Yeah. So it doesn't matter where I am. I'm here, tip, here. Whack. As tight as I can. Right. And I work it. But so on the inside, we'll do this side. Be careful about trapping the finger, right? Breaks. Yeah? I go up. Boom! And be careful about everything. Right? Nice and easy. Change each time. Attention. Let's go.
On your knees here for a second.
Okay guys, c'est très simple. On va travailler juste dans les équipes de deux.
We're gonna work on your knees. No, you're up.
So you're gonna work on in teams of two. Hands on your head. On your knees, you're gonna get shot. Yeah, on your knees. Yeah. Okay. So this is all we want. Alors, vous autres, for the visualized impaired, it's gonna be like this. Mais tu vas imaginer qu'il y a quelqu'un. Pour maintenant, juste pour avoir plus de répétition. We want to get more reps. You're gonna imagine there's someone there. For right now, to work on your brain, there's someone there. Yeah. That's what it's gonna be. Alors. On va travailler étape par étape. We're going to work step by step by step by step. Pour le commencement, la seule chose qu'on veut faire, c'est une déflexion de ligne. I just want to deflect a line of fire. And I'd like to not work just with the arms. Parce que souvent, on va travailler avec le bras. Puis on va pas pousser la bonne quantité ou il va être capable de bouger ou tu vas bouger comme ça, mais il va tourner puis il n'y a presque aucune déviation. A lot of stuff happens. Idéalement, je veux pousser plus vers le triceps. Avec la torse. I'd like to get him off the line as much as possible pour éviter rétraction puis pour contrôler son corps, right? So before I even do, because otherwise people start to do this. Krav Maga! Right, and he resists a little bit, right? So I really want to go, boom, and I want to get off the line of fire.
Si tu peux prendre le bras, c'est bon. Sinon, si c'est juste comme ça, ça suffit. Quelquefois, 10 fois change, aucune personne au sol. One, just pointing at the air. Deuxième principe, encore toujours de déflexion, mais dans cette position, I'm showing you here, on va faire triangulation. We want triangulation. Alors, c'est le bout directement vers son coude. On va chercher une flexion de 90 degrés. We're looking for a 90 degree flexion. Puis à ce point-là, c'est le bout vers le coude. Pas haut, pas bas. Right? Hold it strongly. If he's like this and I miss it a bit, si tu manques ton marque un peu, il n'y a aucun désarmement. Puis en plus, s'il veut faire un serpent avec le bras, snake, you're going to get the sap. Right? So I should, even if he snakes, I want to get it right there. En plus, à cause de ton déflexion, peut-être tu ne vas pas l'avoir tombé ici. Si c'est là, c'est simple, right? Parce que tu as une obstruction. I have that obstruction, so I can work in all those ways. Mais plusieurs fois, ça va être comme ça. Right? Alors, tu dois gonfler ton corps un peu. Right? So you can do this, or I can pull it as I go here, then I use my body. Mais travaille avec tes hanches, ou si vous êtes ici, puis voir comment tu peux faire ton désarmement. Toujours déflexion, désarmement. Toujours. Yeah. Not the other way. We're going to be too far, right? Parce que bientôt tu vas commencer dans les positions moins orthodoxes, mais tu vas rentrer bas. Alors maintenant, imagine si vous êtes à ton maximum, you're at your maximum distance. Des fois, les mouvements comme ceux qui sortent, ok, ils sont pas trop forts, right? Elles vont avoir pas. Mais si tu peux faire une pénétration d'un pouce avec un coup, ça peut être différent, right? So when I hit, ça peut être le main, right? Le ton dit, ou ça peut être la terminaison, ou le main de marteau, mais de couteau, c'est comme tu veux. Mais tu veux jamais frapper juste ici parce que le fusil soit resté en place. So I have a few options. I can hit it and spin it in. My hand doesn't move that much, but it goes away. Yeah? See? So it's a whip, and I stop. And that's where I want to be. That's bad. I can do it to the bottom, mais si tu fais vers le bas, ça va monter. Ça peut tirer. So that's less good. See, they die. So normally, puis son travail, si on veut bloquer la torque dans son corps. Imitation, mais doux. Pour mettre, we take a little pause. Imagine que c'est le même travail. Ah! Mais des fois ça va marcher, des fois ça va pas marcher. Alors on a besoin de continuer juste en cas. I don't want to go. Yeah? Those imitations. So, I go in. Now I'm just doing this so it doesn't hurt. Immediately, je vais mettre la personne au sol et contrôle le fusil. I want to see where it is, right? So I put him down and I keep it. Parce que si mon sujet est là, imagine ici. When I hit, I know here that the gun's not going back towards my friend. Yeah? You go there for a sec, just for that. Visually get back. Kneel. Squeezy, squeezy. Yeah? You're about to kill. Alors, imagine vous êtes ici, right? Boom, I get him. And then right away, I take him down. So I have control. Take it. I move. Yeah? Alors, pas trop fort sur deux coups, c'est juste un contrôle. On va ajouter de puissance, le spank, en 3 minutes. Ok, guys, maintenant j'ajoute des coups. Alors, imagine, vous êtes là, so I hit as I come in, yeah? So, back, I imagine it's there, but if it doesn't go, lutte pas ici. Il y a personne au sol. Faire ton désarmement quand vous êtes plus haut. But I whip him as I take it. So, if this didn't do it, when I'm in that position, I can, même si vous êtes ici, contrôle le fusil vers le côté, mis la personne au sol, puis c'est là on travaille, puis c'est tout ton corps. Right? Don't wrestle. Plonge. Right into the ribs. Save your life. Yeah? Nice and
neat. So now we're putting some spank.
So watch. Same. On va rentrer dans le diagonal, on va rester bas. Right? Idéalement, tu veux rester à l'intérieur de son jambe jusqu'à la dernière instant.
Right? So we're looking for that.
Et maintenant, let's just staying here. Right? On ne veut pas aller à l'extérieur de son coude parce que vous êtes dans son vision périphérique, même s'il est fixe.
It's a sin to turn down MIA, but it's all right.
Alors, quand on rentre, maintenant, on va faire... Oubliez pas, maintenant, vous êtes sur cet côté, tu ne vas pas travailler vraiment avec des déflexions vers ton sujet. Alors, tu peux travailler comme ça, mais la façon la plus simple, c'est un main de singe. Puis on va juste tirer ici. That's all we're looking, right? Le danger ici, c'est que si tu mets rien à l'intérieur, aucune rampe, il peut rétracter les hanches. Puis maintenant, vous êtes dans cette situation. Si ça arrive,
garde cette position, tire vers le bas. So if it does happen, you're there. The easiest way to avoid it is to try to come up like this. And then you get a lot of block here. Maintenant, on a des options, right? So you can just pull, shelf, and take down the body and put weight, pin, drop, depends on the scenario. But we can look for more ballistic too. So watch. Pull, right? Drop there.
It's yours.
It was.
Did you like it?
It's yours. Yes. I can be here and then work there on the leg. It breaks the leg fast. Pop. Choice. I can use my body. Depends on how tired. Si vous êtes très bas, des fois tu n'as aucune énergie. Alors quand on rentre ici, on peut utiliser toute la force. Take it off, right? Parce que des fois, tu dois rester bas s'il y a deux, trois personnes avec les armes à feu. There's a lot of guns, you want to stay low. So we just want to see what we can do from low crouch. Si on travaille juste avec un bras, c'est toujours un fouet. I take it to my body, so that's control. Mm-hmm. Au minimum. Si on veut frapper, we want to hit. C'est le même concept, mais ça doit être un crochet. This is not going to be enough. Puis si je suis vertical, if I'm like that, I have to lift my elbow, I have no power. So it's better to just hook. And then now my block point is here, right? But imagine you gotta stay low, you're too tired, you're too lax, you're hiding, and you wanna go pop, 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 take and move things. Yeah? That's it. Oh, snap. Oh, yeah. Bank. Don't jump back. Alors très simple, guys. On va commencer relativement à la même distance, mais juste un peu plus proche. Juste comme ça. Puis graduellement, pendant les prochaines 20 minutes, on va compresser, 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 puis on va ajouter complexité. Alors avec le fusil, with the gun, we just didn't want to do this. Oh. Yeah. Mais maintenant, quand vous êtes ici, faire attention. Il y a des choses qui sont subtiles avec ça, mais il y a des choses aussi qui sont dangereuses, right? Remember?
Yeah.
You know. So you gotta be very careful, right? Si vous êtes blessé à cause de ton interventionniste, yeah. Boom, mother, Soviet style. You call yourself a spank, boom, and you hit him, yeah. So be very careful. So all they want to see, start slowly. Est-ce qu'on va pousser? In any case here, never, right? Alors, je vais voir comment. It can be anything I want to do. It doesn't matter. Take them off. Maintenant, il y a aucune ligne du feu. Right? It doesn't matter. It can be pointing at them. It's not going to, nothing's going to change. But we just did. Désarmement. You don't kill them yet, nothing. Commence avec une distance, change chaque fois. Yeah. Garde tes coudes plus proches de ton corps et tu vas cacher ton contour dans son corps. Si vous arrivez ou à, pendant le mouvement, prends-le personne dans le couvercle. Right? Alors c'est juste comme.
Sorry about that, right?
I'm in this position. I want to go one. Simple. Sit.
There you go.
Good. So watch what we're going to do, guys. Le même travail, so same work. C'est très important. Imagine s'il y a éclairage devant lui, il y a une deuxième ou troisième personne, on veut être caché entre son cadre. Inside his frame, I should be hidden. So when I do this, if somebody's directly behind me, they can see my elbows, my head, right? So I'd like to be very tight. Maintenant, c'est ton choix, mais I'm going to give you a recommendation to work ice pick, pick à glace. Puis quand on rentre, c'est la même chose. On veut éviter ça. We want to avoid this. Orthodox, parce que souvent, on va couper notre bras. Right? Oftentimes, people cut. So a very simple one is ice pick. Come up, mouth. I don't even care about opening the throat. Mouth, subclavian. Right? À l'intérieur de son clavicule, right? So I should have it. And I put it in. Like that. Quand vous êtes à 7 hauteur, maintenant, tu peux juste trancher un peu. La 5, ça va être l'année. Deuxième option, second option, is mouth, puis juste en dessous de le côté flottant. Pop! Right in. Mais contrôle la personne. Si tu frappes les organes, il ne peut pas faire un son, mais tu peux manquer. So as long as you don't miss, you're fine. So, I mean, that's it, and then I take him down. Penche le corps dans tous les cas 90 degrés. Even if I'm here, I want to get 90, and then I work, and I try to keep him to the side, and look. Easy. Sauf qu'il n'y a aucun éclairage. Come on. Reste au sol pour un instant avec les poumons pleins. Expire par la bouche quand tu lèves. Exhale for the same duration as you rise. Reste vide. C'est du sel. On veut tomber sur l'inspiration. I want to fall that fast. I like to hop it. Right? I find it hard to go out, so I like to hop it. Puis maintenant, 10 secondes. There's no point having a go-to if you can't get to it. So we're going to work a lot on our delivery mechanism. On va commencer avec le marche tactique. We're going to do tactical walk. On sait, c'est, on veut partager la responsabilité entre les deux jambes. We're sharing that load under, by both legs. On veut tirer avec le jambe en avant, pousser avec le jambe en arrière. Tête toujours le même niveau. Si bas qu'on peut tout le jour. As low as you can. So this is what we do. On peut aller n'importe où. Keep walking anywhere. And it's very simple. 1, 10, même si vous êtes vite, continuez. Alors, je vais vider trop vite. I'm going to empty out too fast just to show you. Lève, puis gagne ton respiration. Quand tu marches. You want to get your breath back quiet. Si. Tu peux tirer ton respiration, you can't stretch it, puis tu vois, ça doit être ici là, alors ça. You have to breathe. Do this circuit. La seule différence, quand on arrive, on doit aller là. On veut aller si lent que possible, mais restreint. Keep our arms nice and tight, right? So, you're going to go through, but I want to be nice and tight so when I'm walking, right? Puis faire attention, glisse pas sur les murs, ça va faire un son. Walk around, take big push up. Awesome. Quelqu'un sur ton dos. Maintenant, si bas que tu peux, mais toujours le même montant. Si tu as besoin d'une main au sol, tu peux, idéalement, le montant. Your maximum, 1 minute.
I'm really glad that I know my
place. Imagine si c'est une personne comme ça, right? This is gonna be, first is gonna be like this. Just gonna be standing, right? So, l'autre personne, vous êtes en arrière, the other person is behind. Puis on va juste faire toutes les choses qu'on a faites. Bas, restreint, you're low, you're tight. Contrôle de ton respiration, you're controlling your breath.
mais on va garder les yeux sur le dos pour maintenant. We're gonna keep the eyes on the back. Un, on veut diffuser la vision. Souvent, on lève la tête, ça va affecter l'équilibre. It's gonna start to affect your equilibrium when you bring your head up. Puis en plus, des fois, on va faire des exercices peut-être à la fin. Tu peux sentir plus. Parce que quand tu vois la tête, ça cause un excitement dans ton système limbique. Your body starts to get excited, you start to look, fixate, pulse goes up, breathing changes. It's nothing psychic, but then the other person feels it. Il y a un exercice où peut-être on va faire à la fin, où on met un... on met comme 5 personnes sur chaque côté. Il y a 2 personnes qui vont juste penser des choses agressives. Tout le reste va être positif. Et à l'extérieur, on va être tout naturel. Puis souvent, tu peux sentir. Normalement, c'est comme 75 à 80% des temps, tu peux sentir c'est qui a l'agression. Juste à cause de toutes les choses subconscientes qui sortent. Les égos qui changent, le visage. Right? Some people are horrible at it. They're like, think of angry thought. They're like this. But some people are like this, and even though they think they're being really, really passive, they're showing aggression. Right? Parce que, on dit en anglais que c'est impossible d'être, de mentir avec ton corps. Right? You can lie with your words as much as you want, but there's certain things we do. Il y a des mouvements qui sont incongruents. Il y a tout ton corps, c'est à une vitesse, mais il y a une autre partie qui va bouger lentement. Parce que c'est quelque chose cognitif. Tu penses, je ne veux pas montrer mon agression, je dois relaxer. Tu fais ça, mais tu ne sèves pas. Right? And then the other person feels it. So there's nothing mystical about it. It's not a cheating or anything, but that's what happens. Alors pour maintenant, on va juste garder les yeux sur le dos. Parce que tu peux voir même juste dans mon posture, si je suis comme ça sur la tête, or if I start looking at the guy's head, this starts to happen. You see people starting to go like this, they start to come up too soon, right? Et si vous êtes diffusé, comme dans tout, hein? Dead face. Puis en plus, tu vas être pas perdu dans la psychologie. Imagine, tu dois rentrer, mais tu vas tourner le visage, puis tu vois quelque chose, et suddenly it looks like your brother. Fuck this shit. Take that. Yeah? Nothing personal. Alors, on change chaque fois. Première personne, naturelle. Then it's gonna be your girls. Oh! Yeah, I'm here. That's it.
Hey, thank you, man.
Sauf qu'à la fin, tu vas te livrer un coup, mais le marteau c'est plus simple, coude si tu veux, vers le nuque, mais sans impact. Right, so I want to keep it far. Le défi maintenant, c'est de rester silent pendant tout l'exercice. You're going to be here. Mais quand tu vas donner le coup, maintenant on a le désir d'expirer d'une façon forte, c'est correct, mais ça ne peut pas faire un son. It's quiet right there. Yeah? Watch out. Une personne va garder le coussin sur ton main, à l'auteur de la tête. So, imagine ça, c'est la tête. That's the head. Puis pour cet exercice, on va imaginer le dos, c'est environ le niveau de son coude. Alors, tu veux diffuser ton vision le niveau de son coude. So, I'm staring at the elbow as if that's the back. Maintenant, en place de frapper, on va juste comme merge ou mélanger un peu avec son forme. Right? So, when he's there, I can hit, that's one option, but another way is just to clamp. Alors, je veux vraiment mettre un main sur chaque côté, tourner si fort qu'on peut. Alors, la personne, tu vas garder ton coussin rigide, rigide. So I'm staring, and I don't want to do this. I'm staring, and then when I grab, hard as I can, I want to restrain a bit. But it should be hard, guys, I want to think, because now I can roll into the face and the head, yeah? Simple, that's it, tight screw. Yeah? So what I want to do is this. I'm as low as I can, mais vous êtes stabbed. Faire attention, tu fais pas ça avec tes yeux. A lot of us are doing this. You think you're doing this, but everything's changing. You're stopping. On arrête, on change de respiration. So I can make it loud now, but when I come up, I want to be totally looking forward. Bang! And I want to go through. That's all I want to do. As hard as I can shoot it from that height. À cette hauteur. Yeah? That's it. So what we're doing now, very slow, controlled drop suplex. Yeah? Alors, la chose importante quand tu rentres, pour maintenant, oublie l'entrée. Don't worry about the entry because most people are having enough work. Quand on rentre, la chose importante, c'est que le jambe proche de son corps, c'est élevé. The close leg is elevated ou les deux sont au bas, or both are down. So I will say it again. On peut l'avoir les deux genoux au sol, you can have both down, ou on peut l'avoir de côté proche haut, or we can have the close one high. Never, until I see control, do we do this. Parce que tu peux, même lentement, tuer la personne. Like they will land on this, and even at that impact, it can pop a vertebrae. Yeah? So, this, and if you have trouble remembering shit, it should look like this. So I'm going to show you the trouble remembering shit. On peut commencer en contact. Puis la chose, on a un V ici. We have a V. On veut pas aller sur le côté loin, diagonalement, comme ça. See, this is why we're going to do guys with guys, girls with girls. You're going to have a little bit of tip trot, George. You're so warm. Parce que si on fait ça, naturellement, on va tirer le corps dans une rotation vers moi. And this shit happens. Je veux faire plus comme ça. I know it doesn't feel comfortable. You get used to it, yeah? Like this. And I want to go here. See how warm that is, George? And for now, I can put my hands together. And I'm going to sit him first. Roll him second. And then ramp him up. And put my leg here. Yeah? So I can throttle his throat, knock him out with his knees, and break his back. Here I get the neck. If I sprawl, he's done, right? Even if you're tired, you're weak, yeah? That's the speed you're gonna do it for the next 5 to 7 minutes. Sorry, George. That was really smeary. Jerk. Get it? Sit. And it's fluid. And then when I get here, be very careful. If I block him like this, and I go like that, tuk, that can be dead right here. I can hit. Is this, see, he? If I go like this, what's he going to do? He's going to come out, right? So that's why when I take him over, that diagonal hand is going here. That stops the roll, right? Or like this, and it stops, and I go in. This, neck, spine. Yeah, that's as fast as it is. I'm going to show you 5% faster, which is too fast for right now, and George is fit, and he knows it, and he falls well, and it's already bad, because what happens is the person keeps going straight, and they tear their neck. Is it possible to do this too slow?
No.
Is it possible to do it too fast?
Yes.
All right, change every time. Guys with guys, girls with girls.
I'm getting a new burger. It's
got to be like this, because in application, what we're going to do is we're going to kind of snake. Right? So I'm just going to pop you, and then I'm not going to drop you. Yeah? Yeah, yeah, yeah. But an application is going to be like that. It's going to be really fast. So it needs to be like that. But what we're going to do now, still in the same position, I still hitchhike through, because if I pull this, can I ask you something? Right? I have to be in this grip. Yeah? The only difference is now I'm going to let myself, again, you're going to get friendly, I'm going to go here. Just be careful. Like George's shorts right now, not made for this. I'm going to get a little tug. Most of it's still going to be getting here. Yeah, if I do this, it's technically a rub and a tug.
Rub
but anyway. So I'm keeping tension. Parce que imagine tu dois tuer quelqu'un, mais il est dans cette vêtement. I can't kill him. He's an Under Armour. I don't kill flexible pants. Yoga pants. They're fucking self-defense mechanism. So I need to make sure I understand the fabric. And I pull from both. So if I was pulling wrongly before, it's going to be wronger now. There's nothing wrong about this. It's just so right. Brokeback assassination. Crack! Done. Yeah? So it's that. One and two. Parce que l'instant, tu fais le travail, right? If I'm doing that aggressive, so fast. No. Just your body. Imagine you had nothing left. In there. Yeah? Slow. One. So this is the goal. I sit him first. And he sits inside my knee for now. And then I roll him. Won't be comfortable, but there's no impact. I roll him here on my leg. And I make sure my legs don't do this. Otherwise, I say, I don't have the stability. And then I slowly put him down. On his back, not on his head. And then I take it. This part's less important, because he's going to be very sore at that point. Really dead sore. Yeah? So, I'll leave him on. See? Now they broke because you took them off. So, I'm in this position. Stable. Not like this. Not like this. Here. Nice and slow. I take it. I sit. Take all the time in the world. This is just for distance. So that I'm exaggerating that I have to plunge him between my legs. What?
Then I let him adjust. He relaxes. I said, as he wishes. And then very slowly. Slowly. As I wish. Yeah? Slowly. Otherwise, you say.
You don't have control.
You can say it in any language you want. You can slap him. It doesn't matter. Finalement, c'est loin. So this is the first option. If I can do that one, I can try this one. If I can do this one, I can try this one. But this is what we do now. Instead of being here, we finally get to go up the middle. Yeah? We take the arm. Yeah.
Whee.
How's it going? You look so beautiful. And we go, crook. Yeah. And that's it. I'm done. Yeah?
Try it out.
The meal.
Hey?
For the first time.
If I stay pinched and I try to go sideways very hard, so the first thing I want to do is I do a slap. Right? Even if I go, oh, it's too hard, I let George get up because I don't want to hurt my back. It's already more skilled than you. But if you have, it's got to be one. This will give you the ability, like a curl. If you try doing a sit-up straight and go side to side, not only is it harder, it's dangerous for the back. So I curl. So my ribs can feel. Okay? Yeah. I'm doing my hitchhiker takedown. Do I want to be here?
No.
Here? Or here?
Sorry.
So that's one, two, or three. Which one?
Three.
So now we're going to do it with the leg. So, do I want to be here?
No.
Here?
Maybe.
We're here.
Yeah.
Three. Yeah? So when I put my leg through, if my right leg goes through, it's going to be on his right side, not on his left. Right on right, left on left. That else. Ici, pistolet, pivoté perpendiculaire, en le jambe. There's no resistance. So if he's standing up, strong as he wants, staggers his legs, doesn't really matter. You're never doing it like this. Because that's going to happen. He'll fall in the knee bar. Even if he doesn't know what to do, he's going to grab it. He's going to fall back. He's going to destroy your knee and land in your face. This isn't also very good, right? So I want to be, and do I need my hands? Hands are on side. Do I want to be firm? Yeah? We'll worry about the arc later. We'll worry about all the rest of the stuff. So I just need to see, I can do this. Oh, no, I can do that. I feel bad. Okay? So,
it's okay.
It's all right. So, that's what I want to see. Make sense? That's it. We make it lethal in about 10 minutes. When I see the warm-up, nécessairement, c'est plus sportif. Mais on va faire cette entrée juste pour changer l'orientation, mais pour arriver à la même place. So I'm fucking up. Fucking up the program. Yeah? So this is where I want to be. I'm there. Yeah? I'm front, front, front. So I'm going to slide past. So I haven't been my armpit. Yeah? And then I'm going to take my leg through. I only have one leg. Baby step, my George. Yeah. So, slide through. And then I come through the middle. So don't come through the middle like this. Your middle is going to change, yeah? It has to come through the middle. That means one leg's up, it's a pistol. Like this. But don't worry. Oh. Like this. Yeah. So, like this, yeah? So when I come through, that's how I get it. Then I extend. Don't cross your feet. It's this leg coming down to the butt. And he's tight. Yeah? So again, here. Yeah? Go. Parce que, un, ça montre un niveau de contrôle, right? So one, I should always be able to get my leg grapevine through, because it shows that I have the physical capacity to put my body where I want to. Puis deux, si tu peux rentrer avec le jambe, puis tu choisis de rentrer seulement avec le genou, ça va être plus simple, plus profond, plus précis, plus fort. Right? If I have the ability to come through with my leg, it means I have the ability to control my torso, right? To control it all the way up. And if I can come up high with the body, if I do decide to only do the birther, which is, I can see the head, get it, birther, yeah, like this, it's going to be hard. Otherwise, if I'm flat on my back like a beached whale, and I do this, right, this is really
pleasurable.
I'm pretty sure how you start getting your face beaten in. Excuse me, but don't, yeah? So I need to be able to cradle. On besoin le berceau avec ton corps, right? So the only reason we have trouble is not because we're not flexible, it's because we can't move our body on the ground. We have to be able to move, and it moves from the body. It moves from the torso, from the diaphragm. Right? I should be able to go through without anything. That's how I know I have control. So now if I have that capacity, this one will be better. If I don't have the last capacity, this one will be cosmetic. Right? But that's the whole idea. I don't want to focus here. I want to focus here. We're going to use the outside leg to hook. Yeah. But again, if I hook with the outside leg and I can't lift with the inside, it's going to be desperate. Yeah. So if you're having any problem on this, lift your belt. That's your answer. Yeah. Lift your belt. Yeah. Has to be. That's what's going to give us the power to come through with the knee. It's going to give us the sweep. It's going to give us the contraction. Heel comes to the whoop, and they're going to come down. Make sense? So now, theoretically, a lot of people think this one's easier because they don't have the grapevine, but to do it correctly, to be really tight, everything has to be good from the get-go. Simple. That's it. Try that out. Okay, guys, so natural extension. Watch what we do. Same. Nothing changes. Right? So we're in that position, we take him down. So the leg is there just to help. As soon as I'm getting up at this position, if I need my hand, it's fine. But ideally, I use the energy of the motion. Yeah? So it's my choice. If the hand goes down, it's okay. Just try not to make it too slow. So I take him down, and then when I'm in this position, I want to look to step past the face. Real application, there's going to be brush kick. It's going to be there. Right? Oh. Neck, and then that's back. Yeah, simple enough. So, your nose.